When I was a little boy, the rule for us kids at the dinner table was, you can't get any dessert until you clean your plate. There are people starving in Asia, my mother would say. I think there were people starving in India and China then. If you scrape your plate clean, you get to be a member of the Clean Plate Club, she would say. But you had to eat every little bit of mashed potatoes, every pea, every kernel of canned corn. Why we had the Clean Plate Club rule, I don't know. What I vaguely remember was something to the effect that if I cleaned my plate, I was somehow helping these people. Also, I could get the ice cream. Knowing what we know today about food, which is that overeating is bad for you, I wondered about the logic of this. It makes no sense, I said. I was with my significant other eating breakfast. The only thing I can figure, I said, is that my mother knew best. She knew everything about everything, so if she put something on your plate, it was exactly the right amount for you to eat. Perfect portion control. On the face of it, it's actually wrong, my significant other said. Say there's only a certain amount of food in the world. You eat it up. Now there isn't any for the starving people in Asia. Let me call my mother, I said. This is the 21st century. I've got her on speed dial. My mother lives in Florida. I took out my cell phone and punched her number. Hello? Hi, Ma. Listen, we got a problem here. I explained I was with my girlfriend and described what we were talking about and asked if she could think of any explanation for it. At first, all she said was that that was what everybody was doing at the time, so that's what she did. Then she offered this further explanation. I think you're right. It had to do with portion control. We really did think we knew what was right for our kids. We had Dr. Spock. He had written these books about exactly how to raise your kids. We followed them. So if we gave you something to eat and you didn't finish it, we would scrape what you didn't eat into the garbage. But we knew we'd only have to get more for you later because you'd be hungry pretty soon anyway. So what you're saying is that there was a finite amount of food in the world and I had my portion, and if I didn't eat my portion, then you'd have to get on the phone and call some freighter bound for Asia with food for those children and tell them, Dan didn't finish, so you have to turn the boat around, and then the people in Asia wouldn't get the food? Yep, she said. I finished the call, hung up the phone, and explained all this to my girlfriend. It makes sense, I said. Well, that's a pretty heavy psychological burden for you to be carrying around, she said. I'll just finish up. I keep thinking about these big freighters crossing the Atlantic laden with food, and then a bell clangs and the ship's whistle blows, and the captain sets down his phone and picks up the ship's microphone and shouts, "Hard to starboard! Hard to starboard!"